Welcome back everybody to Dirt Rally. So yeah, unfortunately the last monthly event did not go well because I failed. Figured that I might have been able to try again once the you know, the next stages came up, but obviously I couldn't. So you guys never saw that. But hopefully this April monthly event will go better. And yeah, we're in F2 kit cars, so let's see what we've got to choose from. A Seat, a Beefer, a kit car and a Peugeot 306 Maxi. They're both front engine, straight four engines. They both weigh the same at 2,116 pounds. They both have six speeds and they're both front wheel drive. But there's a little bit difference in terms of the power. The Seat has 270 horsepower at 8,800 RPM, and the Mac 306 has 280 at more than 10,000 RPM. Now, obviously, the Peugeot looks like the obvious choice because it's more powerful and it's the same weight as the Seat. But that maximum amount of power is on a high rev range, and that's only ever really useful for big long straights. And yeah, predominantly the stages on this game don't consist of big long straights. There are courses that have them, but a lot of the time it's corners, hairpins, you know, that lot. So yeah, I think the Seat, with even though it has 10 horsepower less, will have more power to use for more of the rev range. So yeah, we're gonna pick that. I've always wanted to drive a Seat on a rally game anyway, so let's pick a livery. I like that one, red and white and a bit of black there. So let's pick that. Let's see where we're going to be starting. Sweden. Right, we've not been here for a while. So yeah, 12,100 metre track length plus 24 metre altitude difference, 58% snow and 42% compacted snow. So yeah, I don't think we've driven a properly quick front wheel drive car on this game before. Pretty sure those autocross cars were, well, rallycross cars were all wheel drive, so yeah, I don't think we've driven a front wheel drive powerful car. The Lancia and the Mini, though, have about 115 horsepower. Mini have about 100 horsepower. It's decent enough for their age. They're certainly not as powerful as this, so yeah, a properly powerful front wheel drive car is going to be a bit of a you know, learning curve. Right, start. So yeah, I think the Seat, even though it is the same weight as that 306, is a little bit smaller in size. So that should help. Now, even though this is obviously a rally car, the standard version of the Seat Beaver was certainly not meant for 270 horsepower, so unless it radically changed everything, might be a bit of understeer. I just feel like there's some torque steer coming through the wheel. Oh dear. So yeah, as per usual, three stages per episode. One on Sunday and then the next one, obviously Wednesday. Into right 5 long, and to caution crest 40, right 3, into open hairpin left. Ah, I hate the snow. Drags you in. And right 3 over crest 40. Left 5 over bump 40. So I get the feeling this car's going to take a while to get used to be honest. And left 6. And right 6 line for 100. And Sweden, quite frankly, is not the perfect place to be doing that. Left 4 long down, tight. Really 3, rather 100. Treacherous conditions.
Left 3. Into right 5 times 3.
I will say it is decently fast, as you can see.
Left 4 long, 60 over bump. Right 6 long, tight 4 over bump, 40 crest, 100 past junction. Left 4 continues for 80 and tightens over jump, 150 over bumps. Right 5 long over crest. Into caution, keep left over jump. 130 bump bridge, 40. Left 5 over bump, slowing, 40. Caution, left 4 long, open to and tightens, 3 don't cut. And right 4 don't cut, 130.
I've not been on Sweden for a very long time. I don't think we've been on it on a monthly event, quite frankly. So, yeah, the last time I'd have been on here was on the main Challenge Series going for all the championships. So. I forgot about the corner. Don't need to recover. Still on the road.
Right four long. And keep left of the long press. Right 6, 80. Left 6 half long of a bump, don't cut. And right 6 don't cut, bump. Left 6. Into right 5 don't cut. And caution, left 6 over jump, bad camber. And small jump. Left 6 over bump. And right 6 into left 6 over long press, 80 over bumps. Right 6 long over bump. And left 6 over bump continues for 80.
So yeah, not long
80.
Now until dirt 4.
Left 5 over bump.
A couple of months away now.
Caution, 60 braking crest into right 3 don't cut. 40. Left 3 long, 60 crest. And right 4 through deck.
Even though I've not personally heard anything new about it, still, you know, looking forward to it purely because of this game. This has easily been my favourite rally game I've ever played. Now, whether or not that's because I'm taking this game more seriously than I have previous rally games, I don't know, but still, thoroughly enjoyed it. It's, yeah, easily my favourite. That's despite its harshness and relatively slimmed down gameplay, because obviously there's not that many countries to go on, there's only over so many various stages in there. Ah, damn it. Well, that's kind of what happened with the theatre bath that you didn't see, which is why that ended the monthly event. Kind of hit a snowbank like that and just shot over the edge, and apparently that's car wrecked, so. I don't think I was going that fast, to be honest, because I was coming into a hairpin, so I was braking. Maybe I was going a little bit too fast, but certainly not, you know, anything more than 50 miles an hour.
Right 3 long past junction tightens. Into left 6 and right 5 long press bump. Left 6 line top dead. Left 4 40. Caution, left 5 long opens over crest jump. Into right 4 half long. Into crest and crest. And right 3 over bump on 60. Caution, left 4 over crest jump. Open to 80. Left 4 continue to 80, and crest. Right 3 into left 2 long bump. And right 3 tight gun cut into crest jump. And left 5 half long over bumps. And right 4 half long. Into left 5 half long over crest jump 40.
I think I found with front wheel cars in general in this game is that you tend to hit the front more, so a front wheel drive car, for instance, is more susceptible to tyre damage. And obviously, if we lose front tyre on this, we're going to not only seriously lack any grip, but we're also going to be struggling for power, especially if the diff isn't set up very well. So, yeah, because I've when I have lost a tyre, it has generally been a front tyre. So, that's why it's because the front is more susceptible to damage. You're more likely to damage the front, for instance, than you are any other part of the car. So, when I have lost a tyre, it usually has been a front one. And most of the time, it's been alright because I've been in an all wheel drive car or a rear wheel drive car, but if you do it in with a front wheel drive car, I think we did it with a Mini at one point. You were. Do we struggle for grip and power? That's why I'm trying to be as careful as possible.
Right 5, into right 5, keep in. Into right 5, long, continues over bump. And left 5, 40.
Whoa, 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 don't roll it. It's another thing that can happen with this snow. You can dig into the snow and roll it very easily.
Right 4, over press bump, 60 over bumps. Left 5 long, continues over crest jump, maybe 40. To finish.
not the smoothest first stage we've had in a monthly event, but looks like we've not really incurred all that much damage, which is obviously a good thing. Let's check out the replay. See, the car was all clean and pristine at the start, but it's far dirtier by the time we got to the end, which, you know, is to be expected of a rally car, quite frankly. As you can see, the car is really rather small. I think it is a fair bit smaller than the Peugeot, though obviously they are the same weight. I think a smaller car is better to have because it gives you more room on the stages, because some of these stages can be really rather quite narrow overall or in certain parts, so it does help to have a smaller car. Those 306s are certainly one of the biggest hot hatches I've ever made from Peugeot. It's far, far bigger than a 106 or a 206.
And left six, don't cut.
Though I'm hardly showing off the advantages right of having a small car with all those smashing into the snowbanks, etc. Like that.
And right three over crest, 40.
Nearly missed the corner, and that won't be the first time, or the last. Yeah, the car is performing okay. It's one of those ones that's going to take a bit of getting used to, but I'm sure we will. And like I said, Sweden's hardly the place to, you know, get used to a car, quite frankly. So yeah, we're a fair bit behind. That's probably one of the largest differences that we've had, but you know, it's not drastically bad. So let's see. Yeah, we're in the top 100, so that's a decent start. Though obviously we might move up or down the further we get into these stages. So let's move on. Is it still going to be misty? Yes, it is. And it's track length of 7,000 metres, so somewhat shorter. About 5,000 metres, in fact. And plus 883 metre altitude difference, 62% snow, 38% compacted snow. So, the conditions looking like they're going to get worse in this episode because we've got snow. But luckily, it's only cloudy for the next episode, so got that to look forward to. But yeah, misty and then snowy, so hardly the best driving conditions, but you know, considering it was misty last time, we didn't do it as badly as you could expect. And at least this one's shorter, so got less chance of screwing up being a shorter stage.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Hopefully we didn't incur too much damage in the last stage.
Into left 4 half long.
Wobble on there.
Right four half
long. Oh dear.
Line over small crest. Left four through dip, keep in crest, 60. Right three half long, 40. Left three don't cut into crest.
Rather a rough stage. It's really rather rough. Bopping up and down. Playing havoc with the suspension. Like I was talking about how there's not that many straights on these stages, and yet you get Sweden, which has, you know, plenty of its long straight bits as it is. So maybe the Peugeot would have been faster on Sweden, but I guarantee there will be we will be in a country that will have plenty of hairpins, etc. Short, quick straights, so well, you really wouldn't have got the advantage of that additional 10 extra horsepower. Plus it's obviously the extra 10 horsepower that is only above what this car can achieve at its peak power. I'm pretty sure there's more power than just that 10 extra above 9,000 RPM on this car, so probably talking 20, 30, 40 maybe horsepower even more, so I still feel this is a more usable engine. Oh dear. Not that we get to see that when I keep crashing into the snowbanks.
100
past junction, crest jump, maybe. The tyres struggling for grip at the front for the control.
Right 4 long past junction, tightens into crest, and left 4 half long, 40. Right 3, 100. Right 3 long, open over crest, line for 100. Caution bump, left 4, right 5. And left 3, tightens over crest. Into right 5 over bump, 40. Caution left 3 over crest, and open pair then right.
Can imagine this car. Whoa, no, no, don't hit the audience. Can imagine this car being real fun in Germany, for instance. In the likes of Finland with all that gravel. Imagine it'd be far better in those kind of conditions than this. And it's not exactly poor, but you can feel the tyres struggling for grip with these snowy conditions. But it's obviously not just trying to, you know, deal with a normal amount of horsepower for a four-wheel drive car. It's dealing with nearly 300 horsepower, so that amount of power plus snow is bound to throw up issues. Oh dear, all the way around. There we go. So the good thing about it being snow is that it doesn't cause all that much damage when you do hit it. Daisy. In fact, that's the most damage we've had from clipping that. But yeah, apart from that, that went pretty smoothly. Not that far behind, considering. And yeah, the car is in reasonable good shape, apart from that last clip of the finishing board. Well, that should only damage a bit of the bodywork. I doubt it'll damage the wheel all that much. So yeah, slowly getting used to this car. Feel that went a lot smoother than last time, even though we obviously hit the snowbank several times and span out a couple of times, but apart from that, did feel a bit smoother, so yeah, we're getting there. Oops, daisy. Right. Yeah, we've even moved up 27 places, so yeah, that's fairly decent, I think. So let's move on to the final stage of this episode. And we're in the snow, so yeah, this might be a bit tricky, but it's a short one anyway at 4,900 metres, plus minus 96 metre altitude difference, so we're going down. 51% snow, 49% compacted snow, so it's a bit more even on that front, because obviously it is snowing. So yeah, let's see how we deal with even, I don't know whether or not this will be less visibility than mist, but it's not going to be, you know, drastically better, so either way we're not going to be, you know, able to see as clearly as we will be able to in the next episode when it's just cloudy. But yeah, let's get to see how much damage we did incur in those first two stages. Hopefully not a lot. Nope, not at all really. Only the wheels are in 80%. Everything else is 90 and above. So we should be able to repair everything. Yep. Good. Exactly 30 minutes. That's nice. So we've got a brand new car for these conditions. Rode it. Just about kept it in the straight and narrow there.
Left 5, 60 over bumps. Right 3 over crest, 80. Left 4 and crest, 60. Right 4 tights, 3. And left 2 half long. And right 3 opens bad camber, 40. Caution, keep left over crest.
frankly, driving around in these conditions, it feels like I'm on that game Kona that we played. But we're going a hell of a lot faster in this than that pickup truck or snowmobile. Oh dear.
And left four over bump opens and tightens at 8. Keep mid over big jump, 40. Right six long over bumps and left four half long, 40.
Big jump there. I can't handle it well.
Right five over crest jump into left four half long over bump.
Oh dear.
And right five half long.
I felt like we hit a hard bit of snow there, so we damaged the front a little bit. Oh dear. Talking about damage, that will have caused damage.
Left 4 half long, crest jump, right 5 60, right 4 40, right 6 over small crest into left 5 half long, and caution right 6 into left 3 long past junction 40, crest jump, right 5 long and keep left over crest jump maybe. And right 6, 60 crest.
Car feels like it's dragging a little bit for some reason.
Right 6 through dip, and caution keep left over crest bump 60. Left 5 long over crest bump 60.
It's a little bit off on the rear, I think. Never mind. Did it anyway. Don't know why it felt like that. The tyres look like they're all inflated. But never mind, that's a pretty decent time difference. We're on just over 3 minutes, so yeah, I'm pretty pleased with that, quite frankly. So yeah, car's performing admirably despite the fact that we're in Sweden and I'm not the best at Sweden, quite frankly. So yeah, even though we are dealing with a new car and we're in a country that I'm not the best at, we're doing alright, quite frankly. Could be going a whole lot worse, and yeah, the car is performing decently. Quite enjoying it, quite frankly. It's nice to have a really properly powerful front wheel drive car, because like I said, I don't think we've had one before. See how wild we are there, for instance. So yeah, car's performing good, and I'm betting that once we get into a country that I am half decent at, we'll truly see the potential of this car. So let's see where that puts us for the final stage of this episode. Yeah, we're in the top 50. That's solid. Looks like a lot of people have hit the Peugeot, though, to be honest. Yeah, the Peugeot looks like the more popular one. Who's got what at the top? Yeah, the Peugeot seems a bit even in terms of the top 10. The Peugeot does seem to be predominantly the most popular one. I'm guessing a lot of people have gone for the most powerful. It clearly is the best, but as you can see, the Seat is at the top. So yeah, whatever the I think the Seat is at the top. No, the Peugeot, but the Seat's in second place, and it's only 17 seconds behind. But I'm still stick by what my reasoning behind this picking the Seat. So yeah, there we go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.